Away from politics, the government has been urged to allow students transiting in junior secondary schools to be posted in sub-county schools. Educational stakeholders who converged in Nairobi for a three-day regional education learning initiative stressed on the need to address gaps in the education sector.
Regional Education Learning Initiative held its fifth convention in Nairobi, which brought together stakeholders from different organizations. While calling on the government to help address gaps in the sector, the stakeholders asked the ministry to allow students transitioning in junior secondary schools to be posted in the sub-county schools.
We have the children who are transiting to junior secondary posted to the sub-county secondary schools, where they can commute from home, and if in the unlikely event they are not able to commute, they'd be allowed to go home every weekend so that they are close to their parents.
They further called for a review of the capitation model and strengthen collaboration with civil society.
Already a number of progressive initiatives that are ongoing and that really should continue. I would also like to encourage them to explore Rally, because again, this is really a hotbed of budding solutions waiting to find a home within different settings in Kenya to ensure that education for children in Kenya is truly for all.
At the fifth convention, which is under a theme taking stock to inform the future of education, is set to culminate this Thursday.
It's what we are calling upon to address the learning crisis and use methods and innovate ways of ensuring that every child is learning at the level that they are supposed to.
As the government steps up efforts of implementing the competency-based curriculum, stakeholders have been challenged to come up with progressive policies that will help in addressing the gaps in the education sector.